Hey everybody, I'm Corinne Blackstone and welcome to a tutorial. This one's going to be pretty quick. It's just the newest updates for Cricut, but make sure you subscribe to my channel. That way you don't miss out on any of the other fun crafty content that we have coming up. There's going to be so much fun stuff, so you don't want to miss out, and subscribing is totally free. So without further ado, let's get started on the newest Cricut updates. Whatever we would do, we do it just for. If you've downloaded or gotten an update with Cricut Design Space lately, guaranteed you have noticed a ton of changes. So we're gonna go over those super quick and show you kind of the different ways that you can work with Design Space now and what has changed. So I just grabbed an image from their images and I'm gonna show you a couple of things. So you'll notice now that when you click on your image, there are no little icons around your image with the boxes. It's just little square boxes, and that's confusing a lot of people. They don't know where to unlock, they don't know how to rotate and resize and all of that. So I'm going to show you how to do that. So let's first talk about rotate, because I think that one is one that I use a lot. All you simply have to do is take your mouse and hover over just a little bit past where those boxes are, and you can now rotate your image. You can also do it at the top under the rotate option right here if you know exactly how much you want to rotate it. Say I want to put it right back to exact center. Let's say we want to rotate it 180 degrees, meaning we just want to flip it upside down. We can do that. You can also rotate it 90 degrees and flip it sideways, or you can just go back to the typical straight on. Now, if you want to resize your image, you just hover over the box and you'll see that you have the line where you can pull out your image. But a lot of people like to be able to unlock and resize their image that way. They've taken the lock key off of your boxes, but now up at the top, and it's always been here, it's just people didn't really notice it, is the unlock. So if you click on this little lock between the width and the height measurements, you can now change your image scale. Now I'm going to undo that because I don't want it scaled. But you can see that everything's still there, it's just in different places. Let's go ahead and hide this little guy, and I'll show you some of the changes with text next. Now, our text box has changed quite a bit in the last couple of updates. So I'm just going to go ahead and type in my name for now, and that's going to be kind of our starter. Now, one thing that's going to be different is you'll see under alignment, we now have some different options for wrapping. So with wrap off, it means that my word is going to all be on one line. So if I decide to add my last name to this, so I'm just going to go ahead and add my last name. You'll see now that it's all on one line. Easy as pie. But if I have the text wrapping on and I want to put in words, so let's go ahead and do another text box. I'm going to move it up so you guys can see it better. I'm going to go to alignment. I'm going to turn text wrap on, and you'll see what happens is that it goes on to all these different lines. And if you want to fix that, what you can do is kind of just pull your box out and make it larger so that now you'll see that I have two separate lines and I didn't have to hit enter between them. Now it does default to centered alignment, but you can easily change that if you want to. If you want it to be left alignment, right alignment, center alignment, that can all change. And then you can actually change it to where it sits in your box as well. You can do bottom, top, or center. So those are just some more options that they've added for your text box. But you can see I can kind of reduce the size of my text box. I can also like expand it. So if I wanted, you know, to all be on one line, I can do that too. But again, you can just turn off the text wrapping and it will just type it all in one line as well. Or you can hit enter if you so choose, because you'll see on this one, I have the text wrapping off. So if I want them on two separate lines, I can just hit enter and it will put them on two separate lines. So really nothing has necessarily changed when it comes to the enter and putting on things on different lines, but the text wrapping can be a little bit confusing. So just be sure that you check whether your text wrapping is on or off, and depending on how you want it to look will depend on how you want it to appear. Now, another thing that they've added is keyboard shortcuts, which these are fantastic. They're called hotkeys. And you can use them to do all sorts of different things. So we'll go down the list, but I'll have a list that you can download at CorinneBlackstone.com to show you kind of how you can work with your hotkeys. And it will have everything listed out so that you know exactly what they do. So the first thing that you're going to do, and I'm using a Windows computer, so when I say Control, if you are on a Mac, it's going to be Command. So on my Windows computer, if I want to save this, I'm going to hold Control and click S. It's going to ask me to save my project. We'll just save this as update testing. And then you can just hit save. The next one that you have is the undo button. So rather than going up to the top and clicking undo, you can actually use Control Z and it will undo the last thing that I did, which I don't know what it was. Oh, apparently it was messing with the text box. Then let's say we want to actually maybe not undo it. Say we want to redo it. You're going to hold Control Shift Z and you'll see that it'll go back to the way that I had it before. Another thing you can do is use Cut, which is basically like delete, and that's going to be Control and X. You'll see that it deleted my design. You can also do copy and paste, just like normal, which has always been Control C and then Control V to paste it. Now you'll see that I have two of them. You can also use Control D to duplicate. So now I'll have three of them. Now, if I want to select all, I just hit Control A and I can select everything. And then let's say I want to group them. I just have to hold Control and G and it will group my items. Now, let's say I want to ungroup them. It's just Control, Shift, and G, and that will ungroup all of my items. So it's super easy to ungroup and do things like that. Now, I'm going to go ahead and bring up some shapes really quick so that we can show you what kind of the next hotkeys do. It'll be a little bit easier to show you by just using a couple of different shapes. So I'm just going to make some of the shapes a couple different colors just so you guys can kind of get an idea of like what they're doing, what they look like, and we're going to overlap them a little bit so that you can see. I think a little more visual will help. That way you can kind of see what everything is doing. And let's take this heart and let's overlap this heart here and we'll just make this heart yellow. Okay, so we have these three items. So you can actually do things like bring forward, bring to back, send backwards, and send to back, all with hotkeys now. So if I want to bring my square forward, I can just select it. And to bring it forward, you're going to do Control and you are going to do the right bracket. Now you'll see that it brought it in front of our star. But let's say that I want to send it all the way to the back. You're going to do Control, Shift, and the left bracket. If I want to bring it all the way to the front, I go do Control, Shift, and the right bracket. And you'll see now that it's in front of all of our other images. So if I want to do that with the star and I want to move it all the way to the front, Control, Shift, right bracket. And you'll see that it comes all the way to the front, which is super, super, super handy. Now, you can always use the delete button still to delete your images. That still works, but there are some hotkeys. You know, the Control X will delete that. That's cut. So super easy to use. The grouping is super handy to have as well. Now you can also do a zoom to fit. So basically you can make your image as large as your screen. To do that, you're going to hold Control and click one. And you'll see now that my image is quite large on my screen. That is a full zoom. Then if you want to go back to 100%, you're supposed to be able to hit Control and zero, but mine doesn't seem to be working. Not really sure why. There's been a couple hotkeys that don't seem to work. So that may just be kind of a glitch in the newest update. But we can also zoom to a selected item. So let's go ahead and kind of move these apart. And let's select the heart. If we want to zoom to that selected heart, you just hold Control and two. And you'll see now that it has zoomed right to our heart instead of the rest of the images. Now, again, I'm just going to zoom back out since my hotkey doesn't work for 100% for some reason. You can also zoom to a specific area by holding the Z key and dragging. And you'll see I can kind of make a square around it. And then look, I can zoom right to where I designed that little rectangle. So let's say that we want to use that and we want to zoom to our star. You're just going to hold the Z button and make a square, and then you'll see I zoomed into that star. I'll go ahead and go back to 100%. I know this is a lot of back and forth with the zooming, but this is one of their hotkey things, so it's pretty cool. Another item that you can do is to pan the canvas. All you have to do is hold the space bar, and then you can drag your little hand along your canvas and see how it kind of drags it out of screen. And then I can drag it back this way. And there are my designs again. Another cool thing you can do is duplicate items by using the Alt key and dragging. So I'm on my heart, I'm gonna hit Alt, and then I'm just gonna drag, and you'll see now that I have two hearts. You can do it for all the different shapes, words, whatever you wanna work with, whatever you've got. So that's a pretty cool thing that you can do, super easy. Now this one's always been a thing. You can use Control and the scrolling wheel on your mouse to zoom in, and it allows you to zoom in pretty easy and zoom out. That's always been there, but I do find that I use that one quite often when I want to do things. You can also use fun shortcuts like select all, which is Control and A. And you'll see now that I've selected all of my items. Super easy to do. You can also use escape to unselect all. So you just need to hit the escape key on your keyboard and it will deselect everything that you have. Now they do have a toggle grid option, but mine doesn't seem to do anything. I hold Shift and G and my grid isn't doing anything. I've tried a couple different places like clicking and things, and so far nothing. I can still click in the little square, so I can toggle it that way, but the Control G doesn't seem to work at this time. I imagine it will. I hope that helped you out with some of the updates that Cricut has done recently. There have been a lot of changes, and I know it can be a little bit confusing, but a lot of times if you go and just play with it, you'll figure it out pretty quickly. I think the biggest change was them taking away our little buttons on our images, but they're all still there. They're just in different spots. And again, I know that you see that you can't delete. There's no delete option. You can either just use delete on your keyboard, or you can always use the Control X. That's always an option as well. If you have any questions about this or anything else, please let me know in those comments down below. Let me know what updates you want to see Cricut do, because they do listen to us, and the updates that they add are things that we do ask for sometimes. I know not always, but they do see what we say, so we definitely want to make sure that we let them know what we want to see in this program. I hope you guys had a wonderful time learning a little bit more about the Cricut updates. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting.